Hello children, my name is Miss Essen Elizabeth and I'm your mathematics teacher for today, and I'm going to be teaching on the topic plane shapes. Now, what's a plane shape? A plane shape is two-dimensional shape made from line segments enclosing a region. It is two-dimensional shape made from line segments enclosing a region. Example of such plane shape are triangle, quadrilaterals, circle, and other polygons. I'll take it again. Examples of a plane shape are triangle, quadrilaterals, circle, and other polygon. We'll start with triangle. Now, triangle. A triangle is a shape bounded by straight lines. Don't forget our definition of lines. Is a shape that is bounded with a straight line. Okay, that's the shape of a right angle triangle. This is a right angle triangle. We have different types of angles, triangles. We have different type of triangles, but the one I'll be taking now is the right angle triangle. Now, the right angle triangle, this is the shape. This part is called the hypotenuse. This part is called the opposite, and this part is called the adjacent. This part is called the hypotenuse. This part is called the opposite, and this part is called the adjacent. And it is a right-angled triangle. Now we go to the isosceles triangle. This angle, when two sides of a right-angled triangle are equal, when only two sides of it are equal, it is known as an isosceles triangle. Now look at these two sides, they are equal. They have equal size, two equal size. Now these are the properties of the isosceles triangle. You have two sides are equal, which are these two sides. Two angles are equal, these two angles, they are equal, and has one line of symmetry. It has one line of symmetry. We have the equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle. This is the shape of an equilateral triangle. All sides are equal. It has three sides, and all the three sides are equal. This line is equal to this, and also this line is equal to this line. So they have the same lines. All the lines are equal. All the lines are the same. The same length. They are all the same length. All sides are equal. All three angles are equal. Here is one angle, another angle, and another angle. The three angles are equal. Then it has three lines of symmetry. Then we go to the scalene triangle. As you can see, this side is very long. This side is also long, and this side is short. So they don't have any equal sides. The sides are not equal. None of them is equal. None of the sides are equal. None of the angles are equal. You can't measure this angle, measure this one, and measure this one. They are not the same. They are not the same. Now, no lines of symmetry. There is no line of symmetry. Now, I just want you to note, triangle can also be classified according to their angles. Triangle can also be classified according to their angles. One, an acute angle triangle has each of its angle less than 90. An acute angle triangle has each of its angle less than 90 degree. Every angle in an acute angle is less than. It may be 60, it may be 45, it may be 25. It is less than 90. Then an obtuse angle triangle has one of its angle greater than 90. An obtuse angle triangle has one of its angle greater than 90. So it may be 100, it may be 120, it may be 15, and so on, any angle they give you. Number C, you have a right angle triangle has one of its angle to equal to 90. This one is equal. A right angle triangle, like I showed you before, is equal to 90. It has one angle equal to 90. A right angle triangle has one angle equal to 90. Now you have the rectangle. The rectangle has two sides equal. It has two sides equal. This side is equal. This side is equal. It has two sides equal. Each angle is equal to 90. This angle is 90. This angle is 90. It has each angles equal to 90 degree. The diagonal bisects each other. This line is known as the diagonal. This line is known as the diagonal. A line across the other line is known as a diagonal. It has two lines of symmetry. Don't forget, a rectangle has two lines of symmetry. Then we move to circle. Now this is the shape of a circle. It is round. A circle is round. Now these are the parts in a circle. This is the chord. This is known as the chord of a circle. And this is the diameter. A line dividing the circle into two is known as the diameter. A line dividing the diameter is known as radius. That is quarter of a circle. It is known as radius. Then a line that bisects the diameter into two is known as the sector. And this region is known as the arc. Then we move to square. This is a square. All lines are equal. By my definition here, all sides are equal. Each angle is equal to 90. There's an angle here. They are all equal to 90 degree. Each angle is equal to 90. 3. The diagonal bisects each other at right angle. The diagonal, it bisects each other at right angle. When you bisect it, let's take this part away. You have a right angle triangle. So the diagonal bisects each other at a right angle. It has four lines of symmetry. it has four lines of symmetry. Don't forget, a square has all the lines equal, and it has all the four lines equal. A square has all lines equal, and it has four lines equal. That's how to identify a square. Don't forget, we started with defining what a shape is, a plane shape is, and we went further to talk about the triangles and the type of triangles. Then we mentioned a right angle triangle, we mentioned isosceles triangle, and we mentioned the scalene triangle, and we went further to mention equilateral triangle. Then we went further to rectangle. We went further to rectangle. We said the properties of rectangle, which has two sides equal, each angle is equal to 90 degrees, and we talked about the circle and square. I hope you enjoyed the class. Thank you for listening. Bye.